stop arguing. Thanks for watching my video. Thanks for always taking the time to come check out your boy Sills, and y'all have a good day. Nah, I'm just kidding. But it can be just as simple as saying just that. Stop arguing. Arguing is just not worth it. And after so many years, I've realized it just now. It's just not worth it. See, I used to be the guy that had to have the last word. I used to be the guy that needed everyone to understand me. It was like that need of being acknowledged trumped the message I was trying to give to the person. And that is the reason why I was in many arguments back in the day. Being immature and selfish had me thinking that I had to win every argument. But for some weird feeling, and I fought this feeling a lot, but trying to win an argument made me feel like a loser more than anything. So in this video, I'm going to tell you guys and gals why arguing just isn't worth it, and why arguing is one of the main reasons to breakups, divorces, ended long friendships, and so much more. But most of all, arguing is the main cause for your stress. So if you like listening to videos like this, Understanding the Mind of a Good Man by your guy, Sills the Man, make sure you hit that red button below this video box. Subscribe to me. I want y'all to comment, like, all those good things. And let's get to it. In order to become a man of good faith and stature, I had to understand the damage I was creating by arguing to myself and to the person I was arguing with. My stubbornness and immaturity had me thinking that I had to win arguments, that arguments must be conquered. I thought the point of arguing was to get my point across and make you understand me, no matter what. But boy, was I wrong. There are so many reasons why arguing is holding you back, driving you crazy, and killing you slowly. And here are three ways this happens. The first way, in a lot of cases, the right answer to the thing y'all arguing about is known by both parties, but one person is being stubborn or lying to themselves, therefore creating a wasteful argument. Just think about it. Look back at some of the arguments you had back in the past. Usually you were right and the other person knew you were right, but they just wanted to argue just because they didn't want to admit they're wrong. Or you were the one that was wrong and your ego just would not let you quit. You just had to show this person that you were louder and that you have to win. So it's usually one person that knows they are wrong and the other person has the better solution, or that they are right and they are not willing to give up. The second way is both parties don't know the right answer or the solution. Neither person knows the correct answer. So it goes from trying to figure out the problem to seeing who can yell louder and get the last word. This isn't healthy at all. If there's one thing I believe in, is ignorance should inspire education. There are plenty of things I don't know, but at the same time, I have the same energy to get to know those things if I'm interested in them. So if you're telling me something that I do not know the answer to or have no knowledge of, I am going to be open ears. And that is called maturity and willingness to know. But it's ridiculous because a lot of arguments start because the person just don't want to admit to them not knowing it. And it's even worse when both people don't know. So instead of just admitting to your non-knowledge of the situation, you're in a useless argument. You might as well be arguing to a mirror. The third way is people start an argument to get a rise out of you, to test your limits, to push your boundaries, to see how far you're willing to go, to distract you, to bring you out of character, to disturb your peace. Those are all examples of people with motives. It's crazy, right? There's people out there that are trying to trick you. As my grandma says, the devil is always busy. There are people out there who hate to see you happy. They hate to see you in a place that they desire to be. So these people's goal in arguing with you is to take you off your game and get you out of your happiness. This type of argument is empty, premeditated, and nothing but bait. It is easy to fall for these type of arguments if you are not disciplined. Now I'm going to give you four reasons why you should stop arguing, why you should make arguing obsolete, kick it out of your life, detox it, all those good things. Get it out of here. These are four reasons. The first reason is you're giving more power to the other person while you think you are showcasing yours. It's true, right? When someone tries to argue with you, the only power in that is if you follow through. By replying with the same energy, by replying with an argument, you are giving them the permission to argue. But if you just say no, if you are disciplined enough to just ignore it or let it slide, not let your ego ride, then that attempt in that argument is null and void. It won't happen because you ain't let it happen. Stop giving your power away to people who do not deserve it. The second reason why you should stop arguing. Forever. It leads to aggression, which leads to yelling, which ultimately leads to nothing good. There's a very popular saying about arguing. I think it was from Mark Twain or somebody back in the day. And it goes as, never argue with a fool because onlookers may not be able to tell the difference. You can be in an argument, you could be in a debate, and you could be telling the total God honest truth to this person. But from a distance, from far away, you look like a fool just as much as this person because you two are arguing loud, disrespectfully, obnoxiously, and it makes you look undisciplined. What a lot of people tend to forget is that speaking at a higher level does not make your point any more right. In fact, when you speak at a loud voice, it just makes you look weaker. It just makes you look like you're trying to fill a void. And that void is the truth in most cases. So make sure you prioritize the perspective people have on you because someone's always watching. My third reason, when it comes to relationships, most arguments in relationships aren't even game changers. A lot of them aren't even important, especially important enough to break up over. You would be surprised on how many relationships end on insignificant arguments. It's just not worth it. So if you're gonna argue about something, especially with your loved one, make sure it makes sense. Don't lose your peace and happiness over something that can be avoided. The fourth reason why you should take away arguing altogether is because it takes away your ability to master your self-composure and discipline. You don't want to be known as the person who argues all the time, because I know firsthand, every time I see someone I know who argues all the time, I avoid them. You don't want to be the person that gets avoided all the time. You don't want to be known as a person that has no self-composure and discipline, because that is a very lonely life. When you master the ability to not argue and instead talk it out, you master your peace and minimize your exposure to negativity. I wanted to make this video because I realized how important it was, how much change in my life happened when I stopped arguing with people. I became more peaceful, and I also learned a lot more how to interact with people. Like I said earlier, I would take the bait easily because I was hard-headed, I was stubborn. I feel like I had to get my point across. But when I realized everyone doesn't deserve your points, that's when things changed for me. There is power in serenity, and there is more power in discipline. And I also learned a lot of people don't know how to take that response when they try to argue with you and you just ignore it. Or you just let it slide, like, oh, okay, you got it right. Yeah, sure, you got it. Because they're so amped, they're so ready for you to respond, especially if you're historically known as a person who argues. And all of a sudden you don't argue back, they don't even know how to handle that. And what it makes them do, it makes them think about the argument they were trying to start. And if they're open enough, they will realize most cases they were wrong. Action speaks louder than words. And that applies to arguments as well. I'm not gonna sit here and throw my words at you. I'm not going to hammer you with my words. I'm going to let my actions speak. Because in most cases, arguments don't solve a thing. Gotta let your life speak. Gotta let your actions do the work. So thank you for watching my video. I hope this helped. I know there's a lot of people out there that struggle with this. I was one of those people that struggled with argument. I just had to get my point across. I just had to let you know how I felt. But Sills is here to tell you it's just not worth it. Start to work on this at home. And also watch the person's reaction when you don't argue back. So make sure y'all enjoy y'all day. Peace and blessings. Goodbye.